Your love is faithful and kind.
Precious ones, I just wanted to talk a little bit more about this idea of being called shepherdess. As some of you may know, my husband died in 2010. And I was trying to figure out, how do you pick up this work and keep on going? I didn't want to just drop it, but I didn't want to sign up for the real job, the pastoring job. First of all, we had, people who were qualified in the church who could have taken over, could have perhaps twisted my son's arm and got him down here in the South from New York City. I don't know if that would have worked. However, God kept pointing at me while I kept pointing everywhere else. And so one day I'm sitting on the altar and I'm just praising God and I'm magnifying Him and I'm glorifying Him in this wonderful atmosphere set. And I'm like, wow, God. And He says to me, "You are the one," in so many God-like words. And I'm like, no. And finally I said to Him, "Okay, God, if You can give me something else that I can be called aside from pastor, because I don't see that in the scripture. Is there any scriptural basis for a female pastor?" So I thought I had God, up against the wall. "I bet You don't have anything else that I can be called besides pastor." And I heard the words, "Shepherdess." And it was accompanied by such a powerful anointing. I actually leaped from the altar onto the floor. And I said, "Well, what is it? A shepherdess? What is that?" I had never heard it before. Went to the dictionary, and there it was. Webster said it was a female sheep herder. Okay, God, a female sheep herder. Well, I said, "But where is it scripturally?" And then He takes me to Genesis, the 29th chapter and the 9th verse. There I see it in the New English Version, in the NIV. And the King James Version says, she cared for her father's sheep. Rachel was a shepherdess. There it is. And so God also took me to the 7 daughters of Midian. They were actually sheep herders. 7 daughters of Midian were shepherdess? Yes, it's a mind-blowing thing as I keep walking with God. He's showing me that Miriam was actually a prophetess and was called with Moses and Aaron to shepherd or to lead the people of God into the promised land. And when she and Aaron, that is Miriam and Aaron, started talking about, the fact that Moses had married this Ethiopian woman, God called all 3 of them to charge them with this error that they had made. And certainly God caused Miriam to be leprous for 7 days. Long story short, I'm moving in the Word of God. Come to find out now in Judges, the 4th chapter, that Deborah rules Israel and that there is this woman by the name of Jael who actually wins the war for Israel by killing, destroying Sisera with a hammer and a nail. I don't want to go there. But precious ones, I keep walking in the Word of God, and God begins to teach me that the Lord Jesus Christ is inside of the belly of the woman called Mary, and Mary now is changing the scope of everything. God is breaking a law by coming as the Word of God in her belly. And she said, "From now on, all generations shall call me a cursed thing, a woman, a blessed thing." Wow, there's a part 2 to this. Stay with me.